Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. My name is Crazy Segoy, and in this video we're going to be talking about AI coding, a long-awaited and necessary video that a lot of people have been asking for, and I've been skipping around it just a little bit because of just how complex I know it can get, and the explanations are really endless. It's a continuous work in progress, and you're never quote-unquote done with your AI or with your AI coding. Now, there are going to be a number of things I mentioned in this video and in this series that may go over a lot of persons' heads. I'm just going to hope that or advise you guys to do a little bit of reading on your own parts. Join the Hydra Discord. We assist on there. I'll leave the link in the description so that you can follow along and just not get lost in a sea of coding, so to speak. So with that said, let me go ahead and outline a few criteria that you're definitely going to need to progress this. Now, I'm already a level 12 maximum ship, so a lot of the options that I have unlocked, you will not, depending on your level. And to get access to these, you're just going to have to progress over time and upgrade the necessary rooms, which I will outline shortly. So with that said, follow along as best you can. And before I get into it, just a secret tip here. If you join a high level fleet or any fleet that has a max level player in it, that player can code AI to a crew member, donate it inside of the fleet room, and through the fleet room, you can borrow that crew, that donated crew. Let me drop back a crew here. You can borrow that donated crew, and it will automatically have the AI coding that was left on it by the original player. So if I were to borrow this invader here as an example and then tap AI, okay, that's pretty uneventful. But as you can see, that's what the last person using that crew had programmed into it. So here we see, for example, none use special power, origin room, etc. And you can read and pause. I don't want to spend too much time reading AI lines. Let me borrow that crew I dropped before someone takes it. And here we go. Put that back where it should be. These bad boys up here. Okay, so to outline the criteria of what you are going to need in terms of your AI coding and maximizing efficiency, you are going to need your command room, which is going to look like a variation of this right here, your command center, mine is level 9, and laboratory, mine is level 10, yours will look like a variation of this, typically with some tubes. You're going to need to have researched your Python. If you don't know what that is, do some extra reading. This is your Python right here. You're gonna need that at the necessary level. And you're gonna also need your gym. This is the Galaxy Gym, which is purchased in the shop for when it was available. And what you will have on your own ship is the standard gym, which looks like this and is able to train 2 crew at a time. With the Galaxy Gym, I can train 3 inside that room, plus the 2 that comes with the original gym there. So 5 crew within a 12-hour period if I need to. Now, in that regard, let's get right into it. So for this video, I'm gonna need you to have a basic understanding of which support stats support which rooms are supported by which support stats, and the different tasks or roles that different crew play on your ship. What I mean by that is, Huge Hellaloya is a rush crew. He's got the rush command ability, and I've got him trained up to 100% rush. I have a number of Huge Hellaloyas Zin is a Rush crew. He's got the Rush Command ability, and I've got him trained to 100%. King Dong is a can be a repair tank or a border crew with high HP, high base attack, and so on and so forth. Best suited in a role which deals with attacking, defending, or repairing. Zombies are strictly for raiding slash boarding and defense if necessary for your ship. They're poison gas crew. This deals damage to all enemy crews in the room at the time of its activation. Lolitas are repair crews, repair tanks that run around. They have high HP. They repair rooms, and that's pretty much all they do. They soak up damage and ensure that your ship doesn't go down without a fight. So I mentioned this to highlight a few, because you're gonna need to code the AI to the crew that you need it for the task that it needs to be performing. So I wouldn't code my Lolita with border AI because I need her to be repairing. And I wouldn't code my Rush crew with repair AI because I need them to rush my rooms to 100%, right? So with that said, let me go ahead and open up here just to give you an overview of what happens inside the AI menu. So just to get access to that, you tap on the crew that you're gonna want to program AI into. Once the command room is on your ship, you'll have the option to press the AI button, which is in the middle. Tap on that, and I have a little placeholder in there. So you go to new command, and you are greeted with a list of yours may be smaller than mine, as I mentioned before. Bear with me and pay attention, really close attention. So you'll see a number of options that you can select inside this menu. What you're gonna typically want to do is start off with something like current HP below 50%, use special power. This is for Lolita crews. Why? Because Lolita has the Healing Rain ability. Healing Rain ability restores 7 HP to all friendly crew in the current room, including the Lolita herself. So while she's tanking all that damage and repairing the room, and her HP falls below 50%, which is 50% of the 21, so that is about 10.5? Yeah? So once her HP falls below about 10.5, her ability will activate immediately, healing her for 7 HP. Okay? Let me go ahead and do a quick transition here. Okay, so to continue, following that current HP under 50% use special power, now you're gonna need her. The most basic command that you could use is friendly room below 100% target condition room. This is the part that I don't like, the scrolling through the whole mess. Here we go. Friendly room HP below 100%. Go over here to target condition room. And I'm trying to find that here. Here we go. Now, this is the most basic possible AI you can have on your repair crew. If you want to go a step further, you could even drop the current HP down to 25%, use special power, just so she uses it at a later interval, which could save her life in a sticky situation or lead to her dying without her ability activating. So it's on you if you decide to use that code method or not. Now, what this is going to do with this Lolita is this is going to have her go to a room that takes any kind of damage immediately as it takes that damage. So if she's standing down here in my where would I keep her? I'd keep her in I keep her in my laser room, and my android room over here takes damage, she's going to travel from there to there to there to my android room and heal the room, repair the room, and stay in there the entire time unless another room takes any damage. That is what this AI coding is telling her to do. And if this room starts getting fired upon consistently and her HP falls below 50%, that's when she's gonna use her ability to recharge her HP. Okay? Just to make that a little more complex and something a little more viable, a little more serious, we go here, we can have her go to specific rooms that we need her to repair instead of just running around randomly. Let's say that we need her to definitely... Oh yeah, just freeze up. Please wait for 15 seconds. Let's say we need her to repair our laser rooms in priority over our engine rooms or our cloak generator. How we achieve that in the AI coding is we tap on her, tap her AI, we go to new command. We look for laser room below 100% HP, which is what I'm looking for here. This is below 50, below 100% HP, target condition room, which is right here. With this command, she will preferably, or she, with this command, she's gonna only repair laser rooms. So we can plug back the command for friendly room below 100% HP. If I could find it. Bear with me here, friendly room below 100% HP, target condition room. So with this AI code, she's gonna be repairing the laser rooms with priority above every other friendly room, right? If we need her to also repair another room with priority, we look for the room that we need. So let's see here, your missile room HP below 100%. Target condition room and click confirm. Let it take 2 years to actually confirm one single AI code action, and I'm gonna move this above friendly room. And the reason I do that is because the AI code, the way the game is set up, it reads from top to bottom. So if the friendly room below 100% was above both of these, it would be quote unquote true first. So she would not prioritize our lasers and our missiles like we want her to, but instead be running around to every random friendly room that takes damage. So in order to make sure your rooms are being repaired in the most efficient manner, or the manner that you really need it to be, you have to take into consideration that the AI coding is read from top to bottom. Okay, let's move on. So let's look at the AI in here for this Lolita. Now I had her programmed to be boarding rooms, which is something I know I advise not to be doing, but at my level I can just do whatever the heck I want with crews, because the ships, they just melt like jet fuel on steel beams. So I had her with current HP below 25%, use special power, and I actually just remembered what I wanted to look at before I went to that Lolita. So just so we don't get lost here, and I'm going to be saving more of the blabbering and talking for another video, I'm going to quickly touch on all the AI script options, just an overview, so you guys know exactly what they are. So this segment is called AI scripting options explained. Okay, so first we have the conditions, and then we have the actions, then we have the confirmation. So as you can see, there's a large list of conditions that would be met before the crew takes action. Now the ones in blue are things to do with your ship, primarily. Is it your ship? Let me correct myself. The ones in blue are friendly things. Yeah? The ones in green are rooms on your ship. And the ones in red are things to do with your enemy ship. Conditions that have to do with your enemy ship. So your enemy ship, your own ship, and then the crew, the rooms, and a lot of miscellaneous other. Okay? So If I were to just tap on none here, just so we can take a look at the actions. Now, the actions you can take are a lot less complex than the conditions. A lot shorter list. So we have do not use special power, etc., etc., and so forth. The ones in blue are the same as before. As I explained, the ones in green are to do with your own ship, and the ones in red are to do with your enemy ship. Okay, let's go back to the condition here for a second, just so we can I can touch on this point. So if I were to select none, that means that this condition will always be true, no matter what. At any given point, the condition is true, therefore I would use this when I need to take an action just because. If I were to select origin room destroyed, this means that the room that the crew is starting out in, the origin room, becomes destroyed. That's when that condition becomes true. Current room destroyed is for the room that the crew is currently in. Origin room HP above zero, origin room, etc. You should be following or picking up on a trend by this point. The origin room has a friendly crew. This condition would mean that the origin room, let's say I started him or my Lolita in my in my EMP. If she leaves that EMP and a friendly crew enters it aside from her, that's when that condition becomes true and she would take the action that I assigned to that condition. So on and so forth. Origin room is on fire. Current room HP above 0%. Pretty self-explanatory, pretty simple, I would think. Current room has full HP, pretty simple. The target room is on fire. For target room on fire, this is pretty self-explanatory as well. If the Lolita is heading to repair a laser room and it just so happens to be on fire and you would not want her to enter any room that is on fire to save her life, you would go, target room is on fire, continue current job. Meaning that you stay where you are, keep doing what you're doing, do not go to the room that is on fire until that condition is no longer true. Okay? Let me keep moving forward and see what I can see here. Target room HP above 25%. Pretty explanatory. Pretty self-explanatory here. Current HP, which is the HP of the crew itself. Target room HP, pretty simple. Target room destroyed. This is a pretty good one. This is something that you'll see on a lot of boarders or raiders. Once a target room is destroyed, you can have them stay in the room by making the action for the condition be continue current job, or you can have them do other things following that condition. If the target room is destroyed, target your shield room, target the enemy cloak room, target the enemy radar, so on and so forth. Let's continue. Target room has enemy crew. Now, with the same condition or with similar condition as to being on fire, if your Lolita's repairing on your ship and you just so happen to not want her to enter a room that has an enemy crew on it, which has been sent over by the enemy teleporter, you can click target room has enemy crew as your condition. Then you go continue current job, so she keeps doing what she's doing. You can even have her target her origin room if necessary, so that she returns to the room that she started in, and so on and so forth. Now let's look at the green boxes after this sweet little transition. Welcome back from that sweet little transition. Let's continue at the green boxes. So now we're looking at green box conditions, which have to do with rooms that are on your ship and conditions for the rooms that are on your ship. Super weapon, this would be irrelevant for you up until level 12. I'm gonna skip that. Friendly room HP above zero, that's pretty self-explanatory. Friendly room is on fire. Now, for this condition, I'm gonna take a look at my, or draw attention to my cyber duck, which happens to have a 100% fire resistance, which means that if the cyber duck is inside a room that is on fire, it is taking zero damage from the fire. So for a crew like my cyber duck, I would have cyber duck repair rooms that are on fire on my ship because it won't take HP damage. And how I would achieve that is friendly room is on fire. Let me see if I can find that again in this sea of AI. Friendly room is on fire. Target condition room, which is right here. This would have the crew go immediately to rooms that are on fire to put out those fires and get the room back to a normal state, right? Let's continue. Your ship HP above 75%. Your ship has no cloak. Now, for our lower level players that may not be familiar with what a cloak is, here you can see my cloak generator, which essentially if you're a sci-fi fan, you already know what cloaks do to your ship. Renders you quote-unquote invisible, or weapons cannot lock onto you for a short time. That is essentially the function of the cloak generator in this game as well. It renders your ship quote-unquote invisible. Enemy weapons and targeting systems are useless for the duration of the cloak, and your own weapons will also not be able to fire until the cloak is finished or has ended. Let's continue. Friendly room HP below 50%. This is pretty simple. Let me touch on this really quick. If I've got friendly room HP below 70%, target condition room on this Lolita right here, and then on this Lolita on the left, let me see if I can just copy that AI real quick. And this Lolita on the left, I put her with friendly room HP below 50%. If I can find it in this list, 50% way over here for some strange reason. I can't even right now. Like, oh my god. This one is right here. So I'm just gonna select this one because I can't find the 50. Here it is. Jeez. Target condition room. Now, what's gonna happen is the Lolita on the right with the below 75% condition is gonna spring into action first because the condition is below 75%. But for this Lolita, which is below 50% for friendly rooms, she's going to spring into action only when the room HP falls below 50. With this coding, you avoid the both of the crews running to a room that is under fire at the same time, and both of them being melted by focus fire from the enemy weapons. This is an extremely valuable thing to know how to do. Let's continue. Now, in terms of your different individual rooms, if you have priority rooms that you want your repairers to repair first, all you have to do is locate that room, such as this, your Android room below HP below 100%, target condition room. You put that at the top. Let me get rid of that friendly. And then after your Android room, you want your repair crew to repair your reactors. You go to target your reactor HP below 100%, target condition room. Following that, if you need them to go to your laser rooms, your missile rooms, your anti-aircraft rooms, you select it and you put target condition room. And remembering that it goes from top to bottom. So in priority, this is going to repair Android rooms, then your reactors, then your anti-crafts. And then if none of these conditions are true, you can have them target origin room to stay where they need or where they started out from and go back to that room and no longer be standing in the room they were repairing. Okay, let's continue. Let's take a look at the red boxes really quick and tie this video off because it's getting really lengthy and I'm not even sure you guys will stick around to this point, but I'm gonna do it anyway. So, enemy super, this is essentially a mirror of the green boxes. Every weapon and the weapon room conditions on your enemy ship is what you find in the red boxes. Super weapons, enemy room HP above 75%, enemy room HP below 50%. Enemy room has friendly crew, target condition room. For your borders, this can be a really good thing to have. Here is why. If you have telespam tactic like I do and you send 5 crew over to your enemy ship, you don't really necessarily want those crew acting independently on their own if they're weak HP or weak attack points. So this AI code will have those crew join together and travel together. Enemy room has friendly crew, target condition room. What you're going to want to do is have the second or the primary border have a command that has them moving consistently or camping in a room. That please wait is really taking a long time. There we go. So you can have none target enemy reactors. Let me, there we go, found it. Target enemy reactors. So this crew with the friendly crew condition will be following the border crew to every room that it goes to, just tagging along, just making sure, you know, it's not too cold, not too hot, making sure it's feeling okay, motivating them, making them feel good, you know, you're doing good, destroy that room, you know, motivation, it helps. That's just a little humor there. But yeah, it'll be following that crew around, fighting together, repairing, destroying together, and just working together overall, a combined force, making them harder to pick off. The downside of that could be they go to the same rooms together, they run into the same modules and get blown up together. They do it all together. Let's continue. Let's go back to the red boxes. Enemy has no deployed crafts. This has to do with the hangar room. You should be familiar with the hangar room at around level 7 or 8, if I'm not mistaken. I've been level 12 for way too long. I don't remember. Enemy anti-craft room, enemy teleport room, enemy ship has full shield, no active shield, etc. So I think we've touched on a lot. These are the conditions and the actions. You've seen how lengthy a AI explaining video can be. I would definitely have to work on making it more concise, but I don't think there really is a way to compress all this down and make sure that you guys understand at the same time. It has to be covered in a wide scope. Okay, so I hope you guys have a better understanding of AI coding. Even though I didn't get too in-depth with a lot, but you see what I'm working with the time limit that I have. Okay, so with that said, guys, thank you for sticking around. Thanks for joining the channel. Hit subscribe, hit like, share, comment. Tell your kids about it. Remember to drink plenty of water. Stay healthy, you know. I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.